Hello friends, today we are going to understand what is gas liquid type of convective mass transfer. So gas liquid type of convective mass transfer is the most important type of mass transfer in bioprocess technology. Okay, so why is that the most important type of mass transfer? So if you know, we have in bioreactor, we have this nutrient medium. Okay, we have nutrient medium, and if this is an aerobic type of cell culture in which oxygen is required, what we do, we have a sparger at the bottom of the bioreactor. Okay, we have a sparger at the bottom of the bioreactor, and that sparger is going to give us bubbles of oxygen rich air. Okay, the sparger gives us bubbles of oxygen rich air, and now the cells which are present inside this nutrient medium, okay, the cells which are present inside this nutrient medium are going to get this oxygen. But how? Because this oxygen is present inside the bubble. So what happens, this oxygen comes out of the bubble inside the nutrient medium so that the cells can uptake this oxygen. Okay, the cells can only uptake the oxygen from the nutrient medium. So what happens, the oxygen comes out of the bubble inside the nutrient medium, and from the nutrient medium the cells uptake that oxygen. Okay, from the nutrient medium the cells uptake that oxygen. So now if you see this process of coming out of oxygen from this bubble into the liquid medium, okay, the process of coming out of oxygen from the bubble into the liquid medium is gas liquid type of convective mass transfer. Why convective? Because the bubbles are moving and it is a stirred tank bioreactor, the liquid media is moving. So when the bulk of the fluid is in motion, when the bulk of the fluid or the phases which are having the mass transfer, between which the mass transfer is occurring, if they are in motion, if the bulk of that fluid is in motion, then that type of mass transfer is known as convective mass transfer. And here if you see, this bubble is moving upward, this entire nutrient media is also moving in a stirred tank bioreactor, therefore this type of mass transfer is known as convective mass transfer. And when the oxygen moves out of the bubble inside the liquid media, it is known as gas liquid mass transfer. Okay, from the gas phase the mass is moving towards the liquid phase. Now in this video we are going to understand that how to calculate the amount of oxygen that is required. Okay, suppose we give a certain amount of oxygen inside the bubble, but we also need to make sure that an optimum amount of oxygen gets out of the bubble into the nutrient media, because the cells are going to uptake oxygen from the nutrient media. So first we calculate how much oxygen is required by the cells, and then we see the important part, that how much oxygen should be provided inside the bubble so that an optimum amount gets out inside the liquid media. Okay, how much oxygen should be provided inside the bubble so that an optimum amount, the amount which is required by the cells, it gets out inside the liquid media. And now in this video we are going to derive few of those formulas. So guys, if you see, in the last video about convective mass transfer, we derived a simple formula, and that was volumetric rate of mass transfer of a component A, denoted by Na, is equals to K, that is coefficient of mass transfer, multiplied by specific area, multiplied by the concentration difference of component A between initial position and the final position. Okay, the concentration difference of component A between initial position and the final position. So this is what? Volumetric rate of mass transfer. This is volumetric mass transfer coefficient, specific area. This is the difference in the concentration between initial and the final location of the component A. Okay, so suppose we want to transfer the mass from this X position to this Z position. Okay, so this is the gas phase, this is the liquid phase, we have a phase boundary in between, and adjacent to this phase boundary there are fluid films. There are fluid films. I hope you have seen the video about film theory. If you have not seen the video about film theory, please go to my channel and watch that video, because that is going to be important for this particular concept. Okay, so if you see, this is the fluid films, and we know from the film theory that the phase boundary is in equilibrium. Okay, so for just passing the component A from this phase boundary, okay, from moving here to here, just across the phase boundary, does not take any resistance. Okay, there is no resistance to the mass transfer just across the phase boundary, because the phase boundary is in equilibrium according to film theory. So this phase boundary in equilibrium, so if we want to transfer the mass from this X point to this Z point, we are going to do it in two steps. Okay, we are going to do it in two step, that is from x to y and then from y to z. Okay, from x to y and then from y to z. So now let us first calculate the mass transfer from x point to y point. Okay, volumetric rate of mass transfer from x point to y point. So let me write it here, from x to y. Okay, so let me name that volumetric mass transfer as NA1 from x to y is equals to kg. So this is the gas phase, so we have used volumetric mass transfer coefficient for the gas phase, multiplied by the specific area, multiplied by the difference in concentration. So the concentration first at the initial position, that is CAG. So the concentration of component A in the gas phase is CAG. So this is in the bulk of the fluid, that is CAG minus the final position, that is at the phase boundary or at the interface. So the concentration of component A at the interface is CAGI. So concentration of component A on the gas side of the interface is CAGI. Now this is the formula for the volumetric rate of mass transfer from x to y. Now calculate the volumetric rate of mass transfer from y to z. So that is going to be NA2 is equals to KL, because that bulk of the fluid is liquid. A is the area, multiplied by what is going to be the initial concentration. So if you see, y is the initial point, so the initial concentration is going to be CALI, that is the concentration of component A in the liquid phase at the interface, minus the final position, that is CAL. So let us put these terms into the bracket. Okay, so we have got these two terms, but there is a problem, and the problem is we don't know this interface concentration, or practically we cannot calculate this interface concentration. It is difficult to calculate this interface concentration. So now what will we have to do? So now what we are going to do is we are going to eliminate these two terms. We are going to do some mathematics and we are going to eliminate these two terms from this formula and get a formula with only bulk concentrations or some other terms. Okay, so let us do that. So for this, what we are going to do is we are going to use one concept, and that is that the phase boundary is in equilibrium. So this phase boundary, it is in equilibrium, which means that CAGI, that is the component A concentration at the interface towards the gas side, and the component A concentration towards the liquid side of the interface, they are related, because this phase boundary, this interface is in equilibrium. If the interface is in equilibrium, it means that these two concentrations are related, and if we increase the concentration of component A towards the gas side, the concentration of component A towards the liquid side of the interface is also going to increase, because both of them are in equilibrium. So we can say that CAGI is directly proportional to CALI. Okay, CAGI is directly proportional to CALI, and if we remove this proportionality constant, we are going to get, so if we remove this proportionality sign, we are going to get a constant, and that constant is M. So CAGI is equals to M CALI. M is known as distribution coefficient or distribution constant, and we are going to put the values of CAGI from this equation into this equation, and then we are going to put the values of CALI, which is CAGI by M, from this equation into this equation. Okay, so let us do that. So let us first put the values of CAGI from here to here. So it is going to be NA1 is equals to KG multiplied by A CAG minus MCALI. So whatever we are doing right now is to eliminate these two terms. Okay, so you are going to see how I eliminate these terms. So, and the second equation is going to be NA2 KLA multiplied by CLI is going to be CAGI by M minus CAL. Okay, so we have got these four equations. So let me name them 1, 2, 3 and this 4. Okay, now if you see, what we are going to do is we wanted to eliminate this term and this term. Okay, we wanted to eliminate this interface concentration terms. Now to eliminate these terms, what we are going to do is we are going to divide equation 1 by M and multiply equation 2 by M. okay, we are going to divide equation 1 by m and then multiply equation 2 by m. So let us do this. Na1, and we are going to divide this equation by m. So Na1 by m, I am going to transpose this kg on the left hand side. Kga is equals to Cag by m minus Cagi by m. Okay, in the same way we are going to divide, we are going to multiply. In the same way we are going to multiply equation 2 by m. Okay, so here we divided equation 1 by m, and here we are going to multiply equation 2 by m. So we are going to get Na2 multiplied by m divided by KLa is equals to CALi multiplied by m minus MCAL. Okay, so here what we did, we multiply equation 2 by m. And now if you see, here we have got positive MCALi and here we have got negative MCALi. So let me name these equations. So let this equation be 5th and let this equation be 6th. So in the 6th equation, you can see that this is positive MCALi and this is negative MCALi. So if we add this equation 3 and equation 6, this MCALi terms are going to cancel out. And we have reached our objective. Okay, we wanted to eliminate the interface concentration terms and we have done that. In the same way, so if you see here, CAGi by m is negative here and CAGi by m is positive here. So on the 5th equation, CAGi by m is negative. In the 4th equation, CAGi by m is positive. So what we are going to do, we are going to add equation 5th and 4th so that we eliminate these terms. We wanted to eliminate interface concentration terms and we are going to do that now. So if you have noted that, it is good because I am going to rub this till here. Okay, so I am going to rub the board till here. So please note it down or take a screenshot. So now what we are going to do is we are going to add equation 6 and equation 3. Okay, we are going to add equation 6 and equation 3. Add equation 6 and 3. Okay, so equation 6 is Na2 multiplied by m divided by KLa plus 3 is Na1 by KGa. Na1 by KGa. So before we do this addition, we need to understand one simple concept, and that will make these equations even more simpler. That the phase boundary is in equilibrium. Okay, we already know that the phase boundary is in equilibrium. Now, if the phase boundary is in equilibrium, there should be no accumulation of mass, which means that the mass coming to the phase boundary should be equal to the mass leaving from the phase boundary. Okay, the rate at which the mass is coming from x to y should be equal to the rate at which the mass is leaving this y point to the z point. Okay, the mass coming in should be equal to the mass going, because there is no accumulation at the phase boundary. So Na1 and Na2 are actually equal. So if the phase boundary is in equilibrium, then Na1 should be equal to Na2, and we are going to represent these both terms by a simple Na. Okay, so here rather than writing Na2 and Na1, which makes us a little more complicated, we are going to just write Na. Okay, so Nam by KLa plus Na by KGa is equals to, so MCALi and MCALi, this term and this term are going to cancel out. We are going to get CAG minus MCAL. CAG minus MCAL. In the same way, add equation 4 and 5. So if we add these equations, we are going to get Na by MKGA by MKGA plus this equation, Na by KLa, Na by KLa is equals to, so this CAGi by m and here this CAGi by m are going to cancel out because this is a negative term and this is a positive term, so these both are going to cancel out each other. We are going to get CAG by m minus CAL. CAG by m minus CAL. So these are the equations 7 and 8. So these are the equations, and these equations are entirely without interface concentration terms, and we can use these equations directly. Okay. So what we are going to now do is we are going to derive a few more equations from this particular equations, or we are going to derive a few more relations from this particular equation, either to make it simple or to solve a variety of numericals by this simple equation. Okay, so we are going to derive a few more patterns of this equation. Okay, so let me rub this portion of the board now. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take NA common from the seventh equation. Okay, so from, I'm doing it from seventh equation. Okay, so NA I've taken common, and we get M by KLA plus 1 by KGA is equals to CAG minus MCAL. Okay, and then we take the same NA common from the eighth equation, and we are going to get NA multiplied by 1 by MKGA plus 1 by KLA is equals to CAG by M minus CAL. Okay, so if you see the terms which are in bracket, this term and this term, it is entirely constituted of constants. Okay, it is entirely constituted of constants. So can't we give a single constant for this entire terms of constant? Okay, so we are going to put a single constant in the next equation to make it more simple. Okay, so if you see these terms, we can have one more relation with the help of these terms. Okay, so let us see how. Suppose that the two phases are in equilibrium. Just suppose that the two phases are in equilibrium. The bulk of the gas phase and the bulk of the liquid phase are in equilibrium. Actually, they are not. Because if the gas phase and the liquid phase were in equilibrium, there would not have been any mass transfer. Okay, there will not be any mass transfer in the phases which are already in equilibrium. But suppose after mass transfer, they reach a stage where they are in equilibrium. Okay, so which means that the way CALI increase, when we increase CAGI, the same thing is going to happen for the bulk fluids, because these both were also in equilibrium. Okay, so suppose CAG and CAL are in equilibrium. So if we increase CAG, so if we increase this term is also going to increase if they are in equilibrium. So let me write it here. If equilibrium. So if these terms are in equilibrium, if the bulk of both of the fluids are in equilibrium, so this is going to happen. If we increase CAG, CAL is going to increase. So we can write CAG is directly proportional to CAL. Again, removing the proportionality sign, we are going to get a constant, and that constant is distribution factor or distribution coefficient, that is known as M. Okay, so CAG will be equals to MCAL, and CAL is going to be equal to CAG by M. Okay, so now you can ask that why have I put this star over their heads? Okay, why is there a star over the head of CAG and why there is a star over CAL? And the reason is this CAL is the concentration of component A in the liquid, but this CAG is the equilibrium concentration of component A in the gas phase. Okay, so the CAG, it represents the equilibrium concentration of component A in the gas phase. This CAL, it represents the equilibrium concentration of component A in the liquid phase. So this star denotes that these terms, okay, these terms are equilibrium concentration terms. And if you see here, this MCAL can be replaced by, so this MCAL can be replaced by CAG star, and this CAG by M can be replaced by CAL star. Okay, so these two terms can be replaced by equilibrium concentration terms, and we are going to do the same thing. Okay, and in the same way, to make the equation even more simpler, what we are going to do, we are going to replace this entire set of constants by a single constant. We are going to replace this entire set of constants by a single constant. So again, I'm going to rub the top of the board. I hope you are noting it down continuously with me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this equation. So let me name it 9 and this equation is 10. So I'm going to use this 9th equation. So from 9th equation. So what am I going to do is I'm going to replace first these terms. Okay. So I'm going to write this. I'm going to leave a blank for that constant which we are going to see what it is. And CAG minus MC. So MCAL is going to be what? CAG star. C star AG. And now if you see, this is the concentration of component A in the gas phase. during the present moment, and this is the concentration of component A in the gas phase at equilibrium when equilibrium between the gas and the liquid phase is established. So we are going to replace this set of constant by a single constant, and that is overall mass transfer coefficient for the gas phase. So we are going to put here overall mass transfer coefficient for the gas phase. So this entire term, if I write it here, this entire term m by kla plus m by kga is going to be replaced by a single term, that is overall mass transfer coefficient for the gas phase, and that is going to be kga. So a is the area, 1 by kg is the constant, so this kg is the constant, and 1 by kg I have written because all of the constants are in the denominator term, okay. So this entire term is going to be equal to 1 by kg, a is the area and kg is the overall mass transfer coefficient for the gas phase, okay. So I am going to write 1 divided by kga, this is the overall mass transfer coefficient for the gas phase, which has replaced this entire set of constants and made this equation even more simpler. In the same way we are going to do with the 10th equation. So from 10th equation, Na, again I am going to leave the space, and CAG by M is going to be replaced by C star AL minus CAL. So this is the equilibrium concentration of component A in the liquid phase, and this is the concentration of component A in the liquid phase at the present moment. So if I write this entire term here, it is going to be m by kla plus 1 by kga is equal to 1 by kla. So this kl has replaced these set of constants m, kl and kg. So all of these are replaced by this single term, that is capital KL. Okay, all of these are replaced by single term, that is capital KL. So the only difference between this K and that K is, this K is a small k and that K is a capital K. Okay, so don't get confused by how I am writing it. The only way we can differentiate it, this is the capital K and this is the small k. And we are mostly in the numericals, we are going to use this overall mass transfer coefficient. Okay. It is going to be very less that we use the small k or that mass transfer coefficient along with the distribution factor, that is m. In the numericals of bioprocess technology, you are definitely going to use these terms, okay, that is overall mass transfer coefficient. So now we are going to replace this set of constant by this single constant, that is 1 by kla. So these are the final equations that we get after this derivation, and if you see what we have got here is equilibrium concentration of component A, concentration of component A in the gas phase, this is 1 by kga, kg is the overall mass transfer coefficient, A is the specific area, and N is the volumetric mass transfer rate. In the same way here also, volumetric mass transfer rate, overall mass transfer coefficient for the liquid phase, equilibrium concentration of component A in the liquid phase, and concentration of component A in the liquid phase as the present moment. So these two equations are really important equations that you are going to get a lot of numericals to practice from the GATE biotechnology previous year question papers. Okay, also do solve the question papers of DBT JRF, because I've seen that many times that their DBT JRF questions have appeared in GATE biotechnology examination or vice versa. So please do solve all those questions, and if you have any practice question papers, please do solve them as well. Okay, in a few days I am going to make a few videos on how to solve these numericals as well. Okay, so if you have any doubts, any questions, any suggestion related to the videos which I am making, please put them in comments. Okay, thank you.